Hello, my dear students. So in my last class, I was explaining about Schrödinger wave equation for particle in one-dimensional box. So there we considered a particle which is having a mass of m and it is restricted to move in one-dimensional box of length a. So a was considered as the length in which the particle can move in one dimension, that is only one dimension. It might be a x coordinate or a y coordinate or z coordinate. So we understood that in the x direction, that means the particle is moving in one dimensional, that is in x direction. So the motion of an electron which is restricted to move within a small distance of length a, so that is in the x direction. So it can be compared with the motion of a particle in a one-dimensional box. Okay, so for the sake of simplicity, so we assume that the potential energy of the particle is zero everywhere inside the box. Okay, so considering this experimental setup, so we deduced with the help of Schrödinger wave equation, we mathematically derived a Schrödinger wave equation for a particle which is present in one-dimensional box. Okay, and there, so we also understood the quantum number, that is the energy. So the energy of that particle with respect to the quantum number, which it takes the value of the integers like 1, 2, 3, and it was understood that, so it will never be zero. That means the quantum number, so where E is equals to n square h square divided by 8 m a square. So this was the final equation, so which I called as equation 11. Okay, so in that, so n will be the quantum number and it takes the value. Okay, so it takes the values of 1, 2, 3 and it will never be zero or fractional. Okay, so that equation 11, so you go back to my previous class, so there you will see equation 11. Otherwise, so you check it in your notes or textbook. So there the equation 11 is the expression for the energy of the particle in a one-dimensional box. Okay, so later we also understood the observations. What are the observations made from the study of a particle in a box? Okay, so there the expression for energy of the particle in one-dimensional box was given as, so E is equals to, E means here the energy of the particle, E is equals to n square h square divided by 8 m a square, where m is the mass of the particle and a is the width of the box. Okay, so and n is the what is n? Quantum number. Okay, so n is called as quantum number. So this was the observation made by studying a particle in a one-dimensional box. Okay, and next we also understood the quantization for energy. So since n can have only integral values, as I said, it n cannot be zero or fractional, it should be a integral value like 1, 2, 3, etc. Okay, so from the equation or the from the expression for the energy of the particle, so it follows that the energy associated with the motion of the particle in a box can have discrete values, that is the energy is quantized. Okay, so the integer n is called quantum number of the particle. And next, existence of zero point energy. Suppose if n is equals to 1, then what happens? If n is equals to 1, then energy equation reduces to E is equals to h square. Since n is 1, n square means it is 1, so we can neglect it and we can write the energy of the particle as E is equals to h square divided by 8 m a square. And this implies that the minimum energy possessed by the particle is not 0 but has a definite value called as zero point energy. Okay, so with this, considering all the concepts which we discussed, so we also solved a simple problem. So where it asked us to calculate the ground state energy for an electron which is confined to a potential well having a width of 0.2 nanometer. Okay, so the same equation, the expression for energy of the particle in one dimensional box was used, and there we had all the informations which were required, and we found out the energy or the ground state energy for an electron. Okay, so this is where we stopped in our previous class, and in this session, so let us understand the Schrödinger wave equation for hydrogen atom. Simply, it is called as SWE, that means Schrödinger wave equation for hydrogen atom. So to understand this Schrödinger wave equation for hydrogen atom, so it is very necessary or essential to understand the structure or what exactly the hydrogen atom is. The hydrogen atom, it consists of an electron and a proton. Okay, so it is a two particle system. Hydrogen atom is a two particle system, and the internal motion of the two particles around their centers of mass is equivalent to the motion of the single particle with a reduced mass. So this reduced particle is located at R. So what is R? So here you can see, so for hydrogen atom, the nuclear charge is positive, and the charge on the electron is negative, and the potential energy of the electron is given by V is equals to, so minus E square divided by R, where V is equals to the potential energy. Okay, so what is R here? So R is a vector. So as I said, so the reduced particle, so where it is located is called as R, and R is the vector which specifies the position of the electron relative to the position of the proton. Okay, so this is very important. So we have to understand what R is. So R is a vector. What does it implies or specifies? So it specifies the position of the electron relative to the position of the proton. The length of R is the distance between the proton and the electron. Okay, so here R also gives us the information about the distance between the proton and the electron, and the direction of R, and the direction of R is given by the orientation of the vector pointing from the proton to the electron. Since the proton is much more massive than the electron, we assume throughout that the reduced mass is always equal to the electron mass, and the proton is located at the center of the mass. Okay, so this is how we understand a hydrogen atom. So for an hydrogen atom, as I said, so the nuclear charge is positive, that is plus E, and the charge on the electron is minus E. So thus the potential energy is given as V is equals to, so minus E square divided by R. By applying Schrödinger wave equation for hydrogen atom, so it takes the form, so del square psi plus 8 pi square m divided by h square into E minus, so here I am writing, so the value of V, so E minus V into psi is equals to 0. So this is Schrödinger wave equation. Just I am putting the value of V is equals to minus E square divided by R in the place of V. Okay, or it can also be written as del square psi plus 8 pi square m divided by h square into E plus, that is because, so minus into minus it becomes plus, so that is why E plus E square divided by R into psi is equals to 0. Okay, so and let me call this equation as equation number 1. Okay, so here this equation 1, it can be conveniently solved by substituting polar coordinates, that is R and theta and psi, in the place of Cartesian coordinates, that is so these are the Cartesian coordinates. What are, so the this x, y and z, so these are the Cartesian coordinates. So here what I am doing is, to solve equation 1 in a simpler way or convenient way, so I am going to replace the Cartesian coordinates as by substituting polar coordinates, that is R, theta and psi. Okay, so the correlation between two types of coordinates is illustrated in this figure. So this is the figure which explains the polar coordinate system for the motion of electron in hydrogen atom. Okay, so here the distance between x and this z, so that is called as psi, or x is equals to r sine theta cos psi. Okay, so this is the mathematical form which we can give to this angle, and this will be the r, and it is coordinated with p. Okay, so this p will be x or y or z, and z is equals to r cos theta, or this, the distance between these two coordinates can be understood as y is equals to r sin theta or sin psi. Okay, so this is how we can illustrate the polar coordinate system for the motion of electron in hydrogen atom. Okay, so then the relation between the two types of coordinates can be explained as x is equals to r sin theta cos psi, or y is equals to r sin theta sin psi, or z is equals to r cos theta. So in terms of polar coordinates, Schrodinger wave equation can be written as, okay, so this is in terms of polar coordinates. So just substitute the polar coordinates, that is r, theta and psi, in the place of x, y and z. Okay, so we are going to get the equation or the mathematical form of Schrodinger wave equation in this form. So this is the equation, so which I am showing here. So this is in terms of polar coordinates. So the Schrodinger wave equation is written as, so here psi is the function of variables. So where you can see psi here, so that is del psi divided by del r. So this psi is the function of variables. Okay, so what are the variables? So here the variables are polar coordinates. So polar coordinates are variables instead of Cartesian coordinates. So x, y, z are Cartesian coordinates. We have replaced this Cartesian coordinates with polar coordinates, that is r, theta and psi. Okay, so that is why, so this equation, that is Schrodinger wave equation, takes up this form when we consider it for a hydrogen atom. So next is, so the function psi can be written as product of three independent functions. So we can write the function psi as a product of three independent functions, as psi into r, theta and psi. So okay, so which is equals to r, t and f. So this is represented as in this way, r, so in bracket small r, t, theta, f, psi. Okay, so where r is the function of r only, and t, theta is the function of theta only, and f is the function of psi only. Okay, so the solution of Schrodinger wave equation for hydrogen atom yields three wave functions. So what are these three wave functions? So the three wave functions are called as radial wave functions. So that is why it is represented as capital R into small r, that is in bracket. So we are going to represent it as r in the bracket small r, which is called as radial wave function. So this yields two quantum numbers, that is n and l. Okay, so this is l. Okay, so it is going to represent, or it is going to yield two quantum numbers n and l. So n is analogous to principal quantum number, and l is similar to azimuthal quantum number of Bohr-Sommerfeld theory. Okay, so this is what interesting thing what we are going to deduce by studying the Schrodinger wave equation for hydrogen atom. That is, so the solution for Schrodinger wave equation for hydrogen atom, so it yields three wave functions, that is which is called as a radial wave function, and it yields two quantum number, that is n and l, and it is analogous to principal quantum number, and l is similar to azimuthal quantum number of Bohr-Sommerfeld theory. Suppose t and f are angular wave functions, then it yields another quantum number that is called as magnetic quantum number. Okay, suppose if T and F are angular wave functions, so then only, so it is going to yield another quantum number which is represented as a small m, and it is called as magnetic quantum number. By solving Schrödinger wave equation of hydrogen atom, we get expression for energy of an electron in hydrogen atom as, so this is the equation or the energy which we are going to observe by solving the hydrogen atom, that is En is equals to minus 2 pi square z square m e to the power 4 divided by 4 pi epsilon naught to the whole square n square h square. Okay, so this is a quite typical equation which we are going to get finally by solving Schrödinger wave equation of hydrogen atom. So we are going to get the expression for energy of an electron. So here En means it is energy of an electron, and it is given by 2 pi square z square m e to the power 4 divided by 4 pi epsilon naught to the whole square n square h square. So this expression gives the values of energy which corresponds to the different value of n. Okay, so it corresponds to the different value of n. So n might be 1, 2, 3 or etc. Okay, so n can have the integral values. The energy of the electron depends only on its distance from the nucleus. So here the energy is dependent only on the distance from the nucleus, where exactly the electron has been located or situated. So that distance measures the energy of the electron. Okay, so this is what is understood by studying Schrödinger wave equation for hydrogen atom. Okay, so in this, to summarize or to say it in simple words, or briefly explain the Schrödinger wave equation for hydrogen atom. So here, so the hydrogen atom, so the nuclear charge is positive and the charge on the electron is negative. So thus the potential energy of the electron is V is equals to minus E square divided by R. And by substituting the value of V, that is potential energy, in terms of Schrödinger wave equation, we are going to get simplified form of Schrödinger wave equation. And then further what we are going to see is so the polar coordinate system of the motion of electron in the hydrogen atom. So there, to solve the equation in a simplified way or convenient way, so you are going to substitute the polar coordinates in the place of Cartesian coordinates. Okay, and next, so we are going to deduce or write down the polar coordinates with respect to the Schrödinger wave equation. And also we understand that the solution of Schrödinger wave equation for hydrogen atom, it yields a three wave function which is called as radial wave function, and also it implies the two quantum number, that is n and l, and n analogous to the principal quantum number and l is similar to the azimuthal quantum number. And also we understand another quantum number, so which is also called as magnetic quantum number, and thereby we can give the expression for energy of an electron with respect to the hydrogen atom. Okay, so this is how we are going to understand Schrödinger wave equation with respect to hydrogen atom. Okay, so I am going to stop it here. So in my next class we'll see what are quantum numbers and quantum numbers and electron accommodation, how the electron is going to accommodate with respect to the quantum numbers used to refer the outermost valency electrons. And at last, at the end of this chapter, we'll see the comparison of classical mechanics and quantum mechanics. Okay, so thank you, dear students.